Hi, and welcome to the Future of Dermatology podcast. I'm your host, Dr. Faranak Kamangar, board-certified dermatologist. We are here to talk about anything and everything dermatology-related. You'll hear from me and my guests, who are dermatologists, physicians, experts, scientists, residents, and medical students in the field of dermatology. We publish weekly, so if you like what you hear, hit that subscribe button and show us some love, and thank you for joining us. Hello, everyone. This is the kickoff to our Dermatometabolics series. This is a series we've been wanting to do for a long time. We have talked to a lot of our guests about the intersection of metabolism and the skin. And metabolism is super hot right now. I mean, metabolism has been around for a long time, before us even, right? So our mitochondria, which is like our powerhouse, our cellular powerhouse, they were little bacteria. And they joined the eukaryotic cells, and then humans came much after that. So metabolism has been around for a long time, but our celebrities have just brought it back. And this has a lot to do with the fitness industry, the GLP agonists, and also skincare. The 25-26 huge trend in skincare is the energy metabolism, understanding mitochondria, electron transport chain. Something I've been saying for a while on this podcast is, what's sexier than Kylie Jenner is the Krebs cycle. All of that's coming back. Everything you try to ignore in biology 1A, 1B, 101, 102, you know, all the biologies, it's coming back in a real way. And I'm so excited for these few episodes that we're going to have. So we are going to talk about why we as dermatologists need to understand our metabolism, why we should be looking for signs of insulin resistance, and even going as far as testing our patients for insulin resistance, how that correlates with the skin conditions we see in clinic. We're, of course, going to talk about the GLPs, or the incretin class of medications, because it's very important that we touch upon the Ozempic face and the Ozempic butt. So we will definitely be doing that in an episode. And we're going to talk about skincare. So we'll give you a light one. We'll definitely give you a light version of it, but it's actually really important. Don't skip the skincare if you're a very, you know, basic science, basic scientist listener, or hardcore medical dermatologist, because skincare is actually coming back. It's coming back to science. Consumers and patients want it. They want science-backed skincare. They want to see studies done, and they want to see that their skincare is doing something. There's some biological effect. So the science is coming back, which is, you know, fantastic, because that's what we do here at the Future of Dermatology podcast. We talk about science. So we're going to talk about how the cellular energy as the primary driver of aging is making a comeback in the skincare world. And yeah, we're going to talk about the Krebs cycle, because that's what we do. So excited to kick this off. This is all leading up to our SF Derm conference in June 6th to 8th in Napa. I think it might already be full, but if not, do sign up, because it is going to be fantastic. We are going to have an art show, and yeah, we're going to talk about the Krebs cycle there too, for sure. So thanks again. And a huge thanks to everybody who's been following the podcast. It's incredible the growth and support that we have had. It has grown exponentially since 2023. When we started it, we thought people wouldn't follow because we keep talking about things like the Krebs cycle, but you did. And it shows us that people do love science, not only our dermatologists, but our broader community as well. So thank you for helping us expand dermatology knowledge, and the importance of just science-based and efficacy-based treatment guidelines. So thank you so much for following us. And I hope you enjoy the following series. It's one that has been asked about by others. And if you have other topics that you want to hear about, let us know. Thanks again.
Thank you for listening to the Future of Dermatology podcast. Remember to hit that subscribe button and share the podcast with your friends. The more you share and subscribe, the more we'll be able to grow and share our dermatology knowledge. If you have burning dermatology questions, feel free to leave them in the comment below, and we would love to address them in a future episode. And please note that this podcast is not intended to substitute for medical advice from your doctor.